Now, Labour says youth services have been cut drastically since 2010. According to the party's analysis of figures, in real terms, when the Tories came into power, Sheffield was spending £167 in current prices for every child. That's now down to £127 a year. Labour also says spending on youth justice is down and it's linking it to a rise in crime. We can now talk to the Shadow Policing Minister and Sheffield Healey MP, Louise Haigh. Good afternoon, Louise.
Hi, how are you?
Very good, hope you are as well. What's gone wrong then, Louise?
Well, every local authority in England and Wales has had their budget slashed by a huge amount since 2010. Sheffield Council has lost half its budget, and yet their statutory responsibilities have remained the same. So we're seeing the vast majority of spending in Sheffield having to go on adult social care and children's services. And that's meant that funding from non-statutory responsibilities like youth services has been sucked away. It's £127 for every child lost since 2010. And people know what that looks like in their communities. They know that's the youth club either shutting down completely or fewer services being made available. It used to be the case, I know, in places like Woodthorpe and Woodseats that youth services would run pretty much every night of the week. It's now the case that that happens maybe once a week if we're lucky, and a huge amount of what we have now is run by volunteers and not properly funded, trained, qualified youth workers, and we've lost all that expertise from our communities and it's left them very vulnerable.
I mean, the key here surely is that youth provision isn't statutory, and that's the first thing that can be cut. It needs to change, yeah. Doesn't it?
It does, and we've committed for a statutory youth service, because of course when you are experiencing cuts like this, when you are managing budget, then it will be the non-statutory things that go straight away, and we need to be clear about what our priorities should be. And diversionary activities for young people, keeping them safe, keeping them entertained, keeping them busy, is really important, because from my perspective as the Shadow Police and Crime Minister, it stops them falling prey to criminal activity, to organised criminal gangs. And one of the main things that I hear when out speaking to people locally is, no matter how old they are, one of the main things they decry is the lack of things to do for young people. So we need that investment in a statutory youth service, and that will come from reversing the cuts to corporation tax that we announced in our last manifesto, that would invest properly in our public services and in those early intervention and preventative services that, as I say, keep our young people safe.
Apparently, from the government's point of view, there's more money being spent. I mean, Sajid Javid says he'd started a youth endowment fund, funded to the tune of £200 million to invest in the future of the country's most vulnerable youngsters. He said the fund helps steer them away from violence and offers them a better future. What's your response to that?
Well, any announcement on investment is good news after 9 years of austerity, but we're talking about £200 million over the next 10 years in the context of £880 million cut since 2010 from youth services alone, £2 billion from children's services, as we've discussed many, many times on your show, over 21,000 police officers taken off our streets. It's all well and good to announce these pockets of funds now, but the fact of the matter is that the Tories' ideological austerity agenda has removed vital support structures and networks from our communities, and has created the conditions for violent crime in particular to thrive. And that's what we're seeing. We're seeing more and more young people becoming involved with gangs. The Children's Commissioner's latest report showed that nearly 30,000 children across the country would consider themselves to be members of gangs. And we're seeing really nasty criminal organised gangs preying on very vulnerable children, including children that have been excluded from school, but also children that just have too much time on their hands, don't necessarily have the family support that we would like them to have, and they are vulnerable to becoming involved in gang violence and youth violence more generally. And it's all these factors that have seen that increase year on year for the last 6 years.
Yeah, but the increase in gangs and stuff, I mean, surely that's because of being easy, isn't it, on bad kids? Actually, they need to be earlier intervened with, and sanctions for bad behaviour should be more.
Yeah, it's the whole picture. Yes, we need early intervention as early as possible. So our Sure Start was a really important factor of the last Labour government. Again, a lot of those centres have been closed, but we need schools intervening as early as possible, and they've had their funding cut. And of course, we need a really strong criminal justice response. There needs to be deterrence, and people need to be arrested and feel the full force of the law if they are particularly exploiting young children and if they are carrying and using knives. But unfortunately, we've had all those services stripped away. The police are fighting this problem with at least one hand tied behind their back, and all the services that they used to work with to try and tackle the root causes of violence have been stripped back to barely the bare minimum.
Louise, thanks for your time. That's the Shadow Policing Minister and Sheffield Healey MP, Louise Hague.